Paul Baay joins me on Skype today from Touchstone Exploration. Paul, good morning. Good to see you.
Good morning to you as well.
Announced this 10-well drilling campaign underway today in Trinidad. Paul, drilling the first well, that's kicked off, PS602. Sounds pretty aggressive, this campaign. Tell us a bit more.
Yeah, it kicked off on Saturday with our first well, and it is very aggressive. I mean, to put it in perspective, over 7 years, we've drilled about 40 wells, and we're going to drill 10 wells over the next 6 months. So this is an aggressive campaign for us, but something we've wanted to do for about the last 5 or 6 years. Now that we've got the program fully funded, you know, it's pretty exciting to finally get it underway.
Well, that's probably worth a point just sticking with. So this is fully funded because you raised some cash a month or two back, and plus you had a decent balance sheet to start with, didn't you?
Yeah, correct. We had some cash on the balance sheet, but doing that little raise and then also currently we're cash flow positive on a monthly basis. So the combination of those three things not only funds this program, but it'll actually leave us in a pretty good position at the end of the program to quite frankly evaluate whether we want to continue on even further as we go through the year.
So it is early days at the moment, but you're thinking beyond this 10 well program, are you, at further drilling later on this year?
Yeah, so this program, if everything kind of goes as planned, would be done sometime towards the end of August. And depending on where commodity prices go and if these wells continue to perform like the four we drilled last year, I think the board would then look at extending this program for the remainder of the year. And you might see us get in another 8 or 9 wells between the end of August and the end of the year again. So it would be obviously a very, very big year for us.
A big year indeed. Sounds like it could be pretty transformational here for Touchstone Exploration.
Yeah, I think that, you know, like if you look at these first 10 wells, we're running with averages of about 70 barrels a day per well as IPs. So, you know, pretty simple math here. You could add 700 barrels a day, and, you know, our current production is about 1,500 barrels. So you almost have a 50% uptick between now and, let's say, the end of the third quarter when we get these on production. So, yeah, it's pretty aggressive, but they are development wells. So it's a relatively low risk program, one we're obviously very, very excited about.
And some of these early drill locations and areas of high historic production too.
Yes, some of them are. Some of them we're taking a little bit deeper. We're looking for some new zones. And in other areas, what we're trying to do is we're trying to get to areas in the block that haven't previously been drained by other wells. So overall, I think, again, the program has some development and some what I'll call small E exploration, but very exciting on both sides.
And this first well here, that's in the Grand Ravine WD-4 block, is it?
That's correct. So that's probably our deepest block. It's where we drilled a couple of wells in the last drilling campaign. And we're basically following up some shallower zones that we can't produce in the other wells because they're producing in the deeper zones. And it'd probably be, you know, 10 or 12 years till we'll get to these uphole zones. And that doesn't make any sense. So what we're doing is drilling some of the uphole zones to get that production today. So those would be, you know, very low risk in our mind.
And keen to move ahead with this pretty quickly, you got a second rig planning to join the campaign later this month.
Yeah, we really got a unique opportunity on the island. We went with one of the drilling suppliers that we've had, and then one of the other operators on the island kind of pushed their program out by 4 or 5 months. And as a result, another rig came available to us. So instead of going with sort of an initial one rig, we were able to drop the second rig in probably towards the end of this month, hopefully sooner. And accelerate the program. So, you know, the advantage of having all the locations ready to go, as well as having the cash on hand, really gave us the flexibility to jump on the opportunity.
As far as your most recent results are concerned, Q3 2017, quite a significant increase in revenue there, Q3 compared to Q2. We're talking 1.4 million compared to 438,000. That's the direction you're wanting the revenue to hit, isn't it?
Yeah, it certainly is, and that was actually a cash flow number. So that's after we paid all of the expenses and everything. That's not a top line revenue number. And I think the key there is really twofold. One, obviously, oil prices have moved up from where they were previously, but the other side too is that our operating costs have really come down fairly significantly. And the new wells that we drill have royalty free periods on them, so our royalty rate overall corporately drops down as we add these new wells. You get 100% royalty holiday the first year and a 50% royalty holiday the second year. So these barrels that you add in the drilling program are very, very profitable barrels as we go forward.
Well, it sounds as though you're pretty excited, Paul. You're looking forward to the next couple of months.
Yeah, I am really excited. You know, we Touchstone's been around for about 7 years now, and this is really the first time that we've had it fully funded to a point where we could take advantage of this very large oil in place asset base that we have. So the team's really going to be able to perform on what we've done. So yeah, I am very excited about it.
Paul, good to see you. Thanks very much.
Thank you very much.